Episode number 209. I have observed his face. Repeated my name, contemptuously and angrily. Yes. I have observed his face. I have observed his face to be not the face of a true friend of the Republic. Let him take care of his face. And you have observed, my wife, said Defarge, in a deprecatory manner, the anguish of his daughter, which must be a dreadful anguish to him. I have observed his daughter, repeated my name. Yes, I have observed his daughter, more times than one. I have observed her today, and I have observed her other days. I have observed her in the court, and I have observed her in the street by the prison. Let me but lift my finger. She seemed to raise it, the listener's eyes were always on his paper, and to let it fall with a rattle on the ledge before her, as if the axe had dropped. The sitiveness is superb, croaked the juryman. She is an angel, said the vengeance, and embraced her. As to me, pursued my name, implacably, addressing her husband, if it depended on me, which, happily, it does not, thou wouldst rescue this man even now. No, protested Defarge. Not, if to lift this glass would do it. But I would leave the matter there. I say, stop there. See you then, Jack, said Madame Defarge, wrathfully. And see you, too, my little vengeance. See you both. Listen. For other crimes as tyrants and oppressors, I have this race a long time on my register, doomed to destruction and extermination. Ask my husband, is that so? It is so, assented Defarge, without being asked. In the beginning of the great days, when the Bastille falls, he finds this paper of today, and he brings it home. And in the middle of the night when this place is clear and shut, we read it, here on this spot, by the light of this lamp. Ask him, is that so? It is so, assented Defarge. That night, I tell him, when the paper is read through, and the lamp is burnt out, and the day is gleaming in above those shutters, and between those iron bars, that I have now a secret to communicate. Ask him, is that so? It is so, assented Defarge again. I communicate to him that secret. I smite this bosom with these two hands as I smite it now, and I tell him, Defarge, I was brought up among the fishermen on the seashore, and that peasant family so injured by the two Evremond brothers, as that Bastille paper describes, is my family. Defarge, that sister of the mortally wounded boy upon the ground was my sister, that husband was my sister's husband, that unborn child was their child, that brother was my brother, that father was my father, those dead are my dead, and that summons to answer for those things descends to me. Ask him, is that so? It is so, assented Defarge, once more. Then tell wind and fire where to stop, returned Madame. But don't tell me. Both her hearers derived a horrible enjoyment from the deadly nature of her wrath. The listener could feel how white she was, without seeing her, and both highly commended it. Defarge, a weak minority, interposed a few words for the memory of the compassionate wife of the Marquis, but only elicited from his own wife a repetition of her last reply. Tell the wind and the fire where to stop, not me.